everyone, welcome back to my channel. So as you may have already guessed through the title of this video, this is going to be a question and answer round. So I recently posted a picture on Facebook and Instagram, and basically I wanted all my followers to ask me whatever questions they wanted to, and I thought it had been a really long time. I think I did a Q&A on YouTube almost 2 years back, so I thought it was really long. And since life has changed so much in these 2 years, so I really thought that people have a lot of things to ask me. So I got so many questions. There were more than 150 questions, but then most of them were so common with each other, so I had basically clubbed like 15-16 questions in total, and I'm gonna answer all of them. So I hopefully will be addressing to all the questions that were asked. So let's begin. The first question is, what does your tattoo mean? Okay, so I have two tattoos. One is this one, and I have answered this in my previous video as well. This is inked in Chinese, and it means parents, love and blessing. And the other one is here, and it's a star. There's no symbol as such, but just to kind of like motivate myself to be a rising star in life, be it in any field. So I thought I should just get this inked. So the next question is, if you were to be on a deserted island, what are the 5 things that you would carry with yourself? Okay, it's a very tricky question because I can't really imagine myself being on a deserted island, but had that been the case, I would definitely carry water with me, because hydration is really important to survive. I would carry maybe a moisturizer or a sunscreen. Why? Because it gets really dry if you do not really moisturize your skin or do anything. So forget everything, just a moisturizer is really important. I would also take my mobile along with me so that I can talk to people. And I would carry some snacks, like some munchies. And the 5th thing would be, I would take my mom along. Yeah, because I'm really close to her. 3 things you don't like about yourself. Okay, firstly, definitely I am very proactive, and I'm proactive to that extent that I don't really like that about myself. And secondly, I have an OCD. I am a cleanliness freak. Like, I want everything to be arranged in a proper way, and I'm very finicky about that. So that's also another thing that I don't really like about myself, because it's getting too much day by day as I'm growing old. And the 3rd thing that I don't like about myself are my eyebrows. I don't like the shape of my eyebrows. They're very thin and very weird. How old are you? So I am currently 27 years old, and I will be turning 28 in November. Please suggest some body whitening products, because that is one of the obstacles in getting confidence. Okay, first of all, I don't think that should be the issue, because complexion or a person's color, it has got nothing to do with confidence. You have to have confidence within yourself, be it whatever shade you are. I mean, even I'm not fair, I'm medium skin tone, but confidence comes from within. It doesn't matter what color you are. But nevertheless, if you really want some body whitening products, I don't really believe in body whitening, but I can suggest you something that can actually help your skin brighten a little bit, and it will glow. So use homemade packs and scrubs. You can just go for basin, turmeric and curd, and apply that mask on your face. It's gonna give you a lot of glow, and it's going to brighten your skin from within. Or you can just use aloe vera gel on your face. That's also really good. When are you getting married? So I am getting married on 8th of November. I have 5 months left for my marital status to be changed. Are you going to continue blogging after your marriage, or are you planning something else? So I'm definitely going to continue blogging. Of course, there is going to be a little obstacle in the beginning, because I need to set up things in my future house. But I am kind of sorted with respect to the fact that I really want to continue this, and my in-laws, my to-be husband, everyone is really supportive. My family is really supportive, so I am going to continue blogging. But of course, since I'm getting married in November, so maybe a month or two will be really, really haywire. But otherwise, after that, I'm going to definitely be banging on with this work. How did you meet Kunaksh? Okay, for a lot of you who might not know, Kunaksh is my fiancé. I met him 5 years back at a party through a common friend, and the story hasn't stopped since then. So I met him at a friend's party, and he was there as well. So, and we kind of clicked really well and very, very soon. So we took like 5 months to know each other and to understand if we can really, you know, kind of start dating also. So we dated for a while, and then we spoke to our families, and they were very, very supportive, and they all took it really positively. And yeah, so that's how I met him. How do you get time for yourself in your schedule, which is so busy? So it's not like I have a very, very busy schedule. I believe that one must always take time for herself or himself, no matter how busy you are. But how I like to do it is that I like to definitely give one day out of a week, which is just going to be completely like a pamper session to myself. So I'll do my hair spa, my facial routine at home. I'll just dip my feet in warm water with some sea salt and essential oils in it. And I'm just going to do random things, which is really good for skin and hair. So one day in a week, devote it completely to yourself. And you really don't need 24 hours for that. You just need like 2-3 hours to pamper your skin and your hair and your body. And you will feel so good after that. Trust me, I mean, you should definitely follow this regime. I do that, come what may. Smoky eyes or red lips? I think I love smoky eyes. Red lips is also something that I like, but smoky eye is something that I would always, always prefer on anything else. What inspired you to start this platform? So I was always a fashion enthusiast. I was always interested in beauty. Beauty also came from my mom. My mother was someone who really is into homemade packs and, you know, just using kitchen remedies for the skin, for the hair. And she used to be, I remember when I was a kid, she used to be the one, you know, making packs every day and just applying it to the entire family at home on a Sunday afternoon. So it came from my mother, but fashion is something was inbuilt from the very beginning. But then I was in a 9-to-5 job. Later I started following a lot of European and American YouTubers, and I got so thrilled and inspired, and I thought we need more YouTubers in India. So that's how I started my YouTube channel, and I left my job, and then I completely started doing this, and I completely focused on YouTube. So that's what inspired me. Would you eat for rest of your life or sleep for the rest of your life? Oh my god, both of them are really important for me. But I think I would first eat and then go to sleep. What happens to the makeup gifted to you by the brands, and does it get wasted? Okay, yeah, brands do give a lot of stuff. If they have to send PR packages of let's say a lipstick, then they will send the entire range of the lipsticks to you, and you and obviously you can't really just keep reapplying the lipstick every time just in order to get that thing over. So what I generally do is whenever I get a lot of stuff, I do the reviews, and I kind of, you know, do whatever I'm supposed to do. And then whenever my family members, my extended family, my friends come to my place, so I distribute a lot of gifts to them. And yeah, so that's what I generally do, but nothing gets wasted. I gift a lot of beauty items to my mossies, to my chachi, to my mother, to my if there's anything unisex like skincare items, I would give it to my dad, my brother, my fiance, and yeah, so that's how I like to do it. What is the most embarrassing moment in your life? Okay, I'm sure there's not one. There are so many embarrassing moments that have happened in my life, but I can't really disclose them because they are embarrassing, and I can't really remember any one such incident, but if I have to, okay, so there was this one time when I got food poisoning because I ate something random on the street in Kamla Nagar, because I did my graduation from IP College for women, which is in civil lines, and later that was my first year of graduation and I started driving. But then in the first year I used to go by metro from Noida to my college, so while I was coming back in metro, I puked in the metro because it was moving and I couldn't do anything, and I just puked so much. It was very, very embarrassing. And then as soon as the next stop came, I just got down and I went to the washroom, and that was really, really embarrassing for me. What's your go-to signature outfit look? So I think high-waisted pants with a crop top, or maybe like a tank top or an off-shoulder top. That's my current go-to signature look. What is that moment that changed your life? When I started blogging is one, definitely. And there was a time when I thought of leaving YouTube just because of some general reasons, but then I did not, and I just kept on going. So that's also someone really pep talked me. That was something that really changed my life. Current favorite lipstick shade. It's this one that I'm wearing right now. It's from the Lakme Matte Melt Liquid lipstick range. I'm gonna link the shade and mention the shade name in the information box below. Which place to travel next? So technically it's going to be my honeymoon that I'm going to travel next, but I can't really tell this right now, so stay tuned and you will be the first one to know about my next travel destination. But somewhere in Europe is what I can, that's one hint that I can give it to you. What is the motivation that you get when you wake up every day? Okay, so the motivation comes from within. I am someone who depends on myself when it comes to keeping myself motivated. I don't believe in motivation coming from outside. It's the inside energy that always motivates you the most. No matter how much talking I do with you, you will only be motivated if you are motivated from within. So what keeps me motivated is that every night before sleeping, I make a to-do list. And then I wake up in the morning and I just target on that to-do list. So I kind of like, function my mind accordingly that, okay, fine, I have 5 things to do today and I have to finish these tasks. So that's what keeps me motivated. When did you start wearing makeup? Okay, I started wearing makeup when I was, I think, 17 years old, in my 12th grade. And the first thing that I started with was a kajal. And it continued for good 3-4 years. I used to use lactocalamine on my face and kajal and a lip balm. So that was like my entire graduation story. I have used these 3 products through my entire college days, and that's it. So that's how I started doing makeup. Okay, the last question is, where are you going to move after marriage? So I'm going to move to Gurgaon, Gurugram, after I get married. It's not so far, it's all Delhi NCR, so it's all cool. So I hope you enjoyed watching this Q&A round. It was really short because I kind of like crisped all the questions, and I have answered all of them for you. If you have anything else to ask me, let me know in the comments section. Like, share and subscribe, and I will see you very, very soon. Bye.